This is Tesla Model S front drive motor, and this is me trying to make it usable for the DIY electric car build, which might not be the best idea. You see, a while back I found that open inverter design exists that allows you to control Tesla motor. However tempting it was to try to get a Tesla motor, it was prohibitively expensive, so I started to experiment with the Toyota Prius gearbox as a cheaper alternative. But this continued until I stumbled upon a cheap Tesla motor on eBay from Lithuania of all places. I could not resist the opportunity to take things up a notch. Authorizing the payment. Okay, your order is in. We need to wait and see what's going to happen. The good news, I already received an email notifying me that the shipment is coming. The bad news, I have to pay custom clearance and VAT, despite the fact that it's a second-hand item. And would you believe it, it did turn up. And here we go, this is the motor behind me. I was quite pleased with my initial observations, as there were no sign of any damaged parts. The only downside was clearly visible signs of the aluminium corrosion on some surfaces of the motor. And the great extra bonus, the high voltage cable was completely intact. My goal for this task is to remove Tesla inverter cover, but to gain access to the cover, I first will need to remove the cooling pipes and the black foam cover that isolates the inverter top. I also decided to remove high voltage cables to make my life easier later on. Now I can focus on removing the top board from here. I need to remove the whole bottom plate and the board together, because the bottom plate has current sensors embedded in the plate, and they are soldered straight to the board. Having removed the lacquer layer, I started to use lots of flux and sucking device to suck out all the solder from those connectors.
Well, looks like I messed up really badly, guys. Unfortunately, I was trying to unsolder the current sensors, and each of them has four pins, and I broke one pin of each sensor.
In despair, I went searching on the Open Inverter forum and DIY electric car forum. I also posted a question on the Open Inverter forum, but so far no one came back with any advice. And at this moment, help came from completely unexpected source.
If only someone had done all this work years ago and posted it on a video and the forum. The SDU current sensors, I'm Alexis MLX91209CA. Exact the same as Model 3 drive units, usually in stock at Mauser.
I had a quick look on the Mauser website, and yes indeed, they were available. Now, with renewed hope, I started to work on finishing the open inverter board, so it is ready when the sensors will have arrived. At this stage, I decided to actually test the board to ensure that both supply voltages are present, as I did not want to do any more soldering and find out that part of the board is not working. I quickly hooked up 12 volt wires and connected to my power supply.
So we are not consuming any current and power is zero. So what I need to do is to measure 12 volts on the input, and we are getting 1198, only 0.6 volts on after the diode.
I found that in cathode the negative electrode was connected to the 12 volt supply, and positive anode was connected to the capacitor. Obviously, I needed to reverse the polarity of this diode. I decided to check the second Schottky diode in the schematic. The polarity of that one was also wrong. I unsoldered both diodes, cleaned the pads using solder wick, and now soldered them back in, this time using right polarity.
Right, let's give it a try. Power supply is on and it's working. LED is on. Fantastic.
I decided to program Open Tesla Inverter Board before I start soldering any more components. As usual, I use ST-Link Programmer, Program and Verify. After this, I could program the signed firmware. Yes, that looks good. No surprises this time for me. Once I programmed the board and I could see that it was working, I could finish off by adding missing components. Soldering FETs is a bit more challenging. As they have rather large heat sinks, I had to cover the pad and FET backside with the flux and heat the pad for much longer to ensure that solder properly had flown into the pad.
Excellent, guys! Our board is progressing nicely and it's almost ready for testing. I already have a connector and testing harness built up. So we rearranged our power. Okay, now the crunch time. Power supply is on and apply the power. And the switch on and it's working.
I took the approach where I fitted sensors into the PCB first without actually soldering them in, and then I could load the PCB with the sensors into the base plate mounting position and fit the fixing screws.
Okay, now we can assemble the board. Two of the high voltage cables will go through these.
I finished the assembly of the board and I just needed to fit in the bracket directing the three-phase high voltage cable that's connected to the motor terminals. Installing inverter back was a very simple affair. To finish off, all I needed to do is to attach the three screws that holding the phases that go from the inverter into the motor.
I have my setup here, which some people may call Heath Robinson, but for the first test I think it's gonna be okay. So these connectors really work well. So they plug in into the high voltage cable and fit very nicely. So the rest of setup is here. So we have pre-charge contactor, main contactor, pre-charge resistor, and our famous Prius throttle pedal.
And for the first test, I decided to connect in the bulb to work as a some sort of a protection limiting current device, as well as an indicator. The amount of glow will increase with proportion of current drawn by the inverter.
Right, so now we're gonna try the first run. You can see that the bulb is flushed. Yeah, pre-charge is closed. And main contactor is open. High voltage power supply is on. Now I'm switching the low voltage power supply. So now 12 volts is enabled. And we have rotation. Unbelievable. So this is our pedal. I press the pedal. And you hopefully can see that motor is rotating. Put the motor in reverse. And it's going in reverse. Wow, the motor is working. What a relief. When I damaged the current sensors, I did not think I will ever get it to spin again.
My initial plan was to go for the Lexus GS450H gearbox and inverter. To control Lexus inverter, I ordered Zombieverter VCU. But this was disrupted by unexpected eBay find of the cheap Tesla Model S front drive motor. Will this make Zombieverter VCU redundant? No, as it will help with controlling all other aspects of the vehicle, and I can interface it to the Open Inverter board that will be controlling the Tesla motor. I received this board with some of the components missing, and I have to solder them in. As the shipment from Mauser arrived a while ago, it's time to get crafty with some soldering. I've got all my components ready and just waiting to be unpacked. And because I like to keep things organized, I'm starting with the smaller ICs. I follow my trusty soldering technique, which is basically just a lot of flux and gentle touch with my soldering iron. And finally, it's time for the big guns, the MOSFET transistors. I follow the same principle, but it just need a little bit extra TLC, since these guys have a larger tap at the back. I have to heat it up for a bit longer to make sure the solder flows through properly. Before I could power up the zombie board for the first time, I needed to make sure that the current supply is limited. This has to be done so I won't damage the board too badly. I settled on limiting current to 200 milliamp in the end. Now I just need to hook up the power supply and will it work? Will it work? Press the power button and we got a light. At least that means that 3.3 volts is working. Just to finish off the first power on test, I needed to measure all supply voltages. The best place to measure those voltages would be tantalum capacitors C23 and C13. I could guess that 5 volts is working too, as 3.3 volt is derived from 5 volt supply. But let's just measure it for fun. Okay, now is the time to breathe in some life into our zombie board. On the board, I soldered 3-pin connector, clock, data and ground. Just get those connected and plug into USB port of my laptop. I need to power the board and it will be ready for programming. Using ST-Link utility, I programmed bootloader and the actual software itself. Everything's working fine by looks of it. To test the zombie board, I decided to use Toyota Prius inverter and the gearbox I already had in my possession. So this is my first setup. So it will be reverse forward switch, start button and the ignition switch. So I'm only using this part. Okay, now time to do first functional test. So I got all the wires in place, all the switches in place, and now it's time to try to see if it actually works. So this is our harness. Now put this on. It's quite a nice locking mechanism. And now we can turn the power supply on. Here we go. So I can now see that light is flashing, so the power is applied correctly, which is already a good sign. At this point on, I went through pressing all the buttons and switching all the switches and making sure they're working by checking their status in web interface. Everything appears to be working well. Okay, so I now crimped all the cables and I connected the throttle pedal. With the throttle pedal connected, I wanted to make sure it's working, so I plotted the graph on the web interface of port 1 and port 2 and checked that the response was appropriate on the web interface as well. Testing the board with the Toyota Prius inverter and gearbox. So we have the VCU contactor. We have two gray cables which basically connect Toyota asynchronous communication. And we have our start button, our direction and our ignition. And we have a Toyota Iris throttle. So we switch on the high voltage system, and also our inverter is wired with the resolver for MG2 and MG1. So we switch ignition switch and start button, which should engage the contactor. And I can hear the inverter whine. And at this stage, I'm gonna switch direction, try the throttle pedal. So now the VCU board is working, I'm ready to move on to the next chapter. And well, of course I will tell you about this in the next video.